see whenever I've asked people in the survey if they have. 7 said no, so those 7 now have. And according to my survey, 16 of the 19 people who replied either knew exactly what a brain break was or they had a general idea. So what is a brain break? Brain breaks are short, 1 to 5 minute physical activities that help students remain focused and can either energize them or relax them. And normally in elementary school, they're done 3 to 4 times a day. And a great website for brain breaks is actually Go Noodle, and it has breathing exercises, yoga, stretching, dancing, and music, and a lot of teachers use this in their classroom now. So brain breaks are an important tool used by teachers because they implement physical activity, they increase students' moods, they help students retain focus and retain information, and they regain the students' focus. And during my speech, I will tell you guys why they are so important to teachers. First, I'm talking about how they implement physical activity. And by implementing physical activity through brain break, students receive more time to be active throughout the day. And if you're a teacher or going to be a teacher, schools are taking away recess time and gym time and extracurricular activities to be brought in more curriculum time. So with these little short brain breaks, it helps the students get more time to be physical throughout the day. And it also increases the blood flow and the oxygen sent to the brain. So whenever students get tired, they just do a little brain break and it helps the students wake up and get them ready for the rest of their work. And Dr. Laura Chaddick-Heyman, a research scientist specializing in movement in the brain, stated, "Research shows even short bursts of movement deliver big benefits for brain health and academic performance relative to sitting." So when participating in a brain break, students' moods improve as well. So just students' anticipation of brain breaks allows them to be more positive because they're looking forward to something throughout the day. They know that they're not going to be in their seats for the entire day. So that helps them be more happy, be happier, and allows them to want to come to school. As I said, students have a more positive outlook on learning and being at school. They actually enjoy the things that they're doing. A 6th grade teacher, Andrew Morrell, says, "Since using brain breaks with young adolescents, I have witnessed an increase in positive community. They have also been effective in supporting students when misbehavior occurs." So if he realizes that students are starting to act up, he can just stop his class and do a short brain break. And when students are given a chance to take a break, their brains have time to store information. Information and retention is increased during brain breaks because the work has time to be stored into their brains. So breathing exercises are great opportunities for information retention because they don't have to be up running around the classroom. If the teacher realizes that the students are starting to lose focus, he has them stop their work. You can have them just start doing a few deep breaths like I had you guys do, and that allows them to think about what they're doing and move on. And once they are done with the brain break, they can get back to work. And according to the website, School of Medicine, if you are halfway through learning something and are then interrupted in what you are doing, you will remember what you are doing better than if you had completed the learning task. And last, after a brain break, old information is retained, and students are able to regain focus on the task at hand. Students can't focus on more than one thing at a time. And as you can see, I put 5 to 6-year-olds can stay focused for about 10 to 15 minutes, and 6 to 7-year-olds can stay focused for up to a half an hour, which is not a long time in a classroom whenever you're supposed to be getting work done all day long. So you just have them, it says about every 30 minutes to 45 minutes, you can do a short little brain break, have them get up and dance, and then they're ready to sit down and get back to work. And in the article, Incorporating Brain Breaks, Keeping Students Engaged, I learned that research indicates that the brain breaks also improve students' concentration and relief of stress. So, at the end of the day, brain breaks increase learning by decreasing the amount of curricular learning. Brain breaks are beneficial to students and teachers because they implement physical activity, improve students' moods, students retain information and regain the students' focus. And they aid the teacher at keeping the students more well-behaved and on task. And most of the students in this class either strongly agree or agree that brain breaks are helpful to students. So now that I have told you everything, I hope that you guys can maybe take brain breaks into your own life, and if you're studying, you can take a brain break, and it'll help you restore your information.